But it's only because we can't wait to talk about our other favorite topic, airport charges, which I'm about to come to. The Commission has been evaluating the European Airport Charges Directive since 2016, but we're still waiting for the final report, unfortunately. And meanwhile, the fees that airlines pay to use these airports, which is basically the fees our passengers pay, continue to increase, and the need for reform, I think, is becoming more and more urgent. And in addition to the trend shown on the chart behind me, just a few facts maybe which I think are quite interesting. A study in 2017 done by the European Commission found that the largest European airports raised charges by 23% in average from 2009 to 2016. 20 of Europe's largest airports even increased their charges by more than 40% in that period, and a handful even of airports managed to increase their charges by 100% in those 7 years. And some of these airports by now have EBITDA margins of up to 60 to 70% above the world average of already 47%, quite a high number in itself. And I think we would all agree there's very, very few industries who can compare to this and show this kind of margin. So you might wonder, how is this possible? And the answer is quite simple. Some airports just have significant market power and they just use it. The basically acting independently of the interests of airlines and of our passengers by basically charging excessively without being afraid of losing business. Why? Because they are local monopolies. And that drives up the cost of flying, which obviously is something we don't like. Especially since, by contrast, the intense competition, not only among the financier, but all the European players in the airline industry, has lowered fares over the last years and increased connectivity and increased choices. But those gains coming from more competitiveness from us could be reversed if nothing is done to regulate those significant charges in airports. Therefore, the revised airport charge directive is needed, and recently Airlines for Europe and IATA have done a study to analyze which factors actually make airports behave more competitive. And they developed in this study a very simple yet very robust model how to do this. Basically, with repeat tests being done with airports for 5 million passengers each. And these tests will give regulators a very accurate indication of whether an airport has significant market power and needs to be regulated or not. And it's much less time consuming than what we have so far, where member states are doing very complex models like market power assessments, which basically have shown not to be as useful as we thought. So we actually showed that way of measuring significant market power to a group of regulators, the so-called Thessaloniki Forum, and they actually believe that there's very relevant questions and they recognize that such criteria should be used to regulate airports. And I think going forward, such models can be used, shall be used, and by must be used by the Commission as a blueprint to finally reform the Airport Charges Directive. And I think in the end, we're not doing this for us, we're doing it for our passengers. And they are the ones who enjoy Europe as one of the most open travel environments in the world, so we want to keep it that way. And if you look at the state of Europe, what more can be done to keep Europe together and allow people to connect with each other? And that's what the five of us here and the other industries, players in this room or outside this room, stand for. Thank you.